Hi, this could only be Rides with Chuck. I just got back from an event of the Illinois Live Steamers, a private club of railroad enthusiasts who work and play on a 7-acre train layout. I had a chance to talk with one of their members.
Well, right now I'm just getting the steam up here. Looks like we hit it. Go to 125 PSI. Have the blower on to keep the oxygen going through here to make sure I got a nice blue flame inside here. There are 48 burners in there at about 2,500 BTU each. So it's like 120 some odd BTU I have in there. I have a 40-pound propane tank in here, horizontal. That's pretty good. I run on about 1 PSI, and I could probably run a full 8 hours plus on one tank.
What is this locomotive?
This is a Southern Pacific Daylight GS4. It was made in the early 40s.
How many were there?
Oh, now you're, boy, the GS4s, it's probably, I'm guessing around 15, 20 maybe.
Okay.
You know, I don't know the exact number on that,
so
but.
It wasn't like hundreds.
No, because they had the GS3s, GS2s, and GS1s also. Then they also had GS5 after this, which had bearings on it and stuff, but they didn't build many of those because that was during World War II.
So you bought this complete?
Oh, no, I built it from scratch. Yeah, I did all the drawings myself. I have over 5,000 hours into it over an 11-year period.
I don't know where to even start.
Well, research. The internet helped a lot. I bought a bunch of books. I've got a lot of books at home, my own library. But there's people, too, in California, Youngling, that I've called him, Ed Youngling, that has built beautiful ones. I mean, if I had his, I'd throw this one away. His are museum pieces. They're beautiful. But I got blueprints, too, from different areas, you know, of the original engine and things. And then the rest, I just took measurements, made my own drawings, and scaled it down. And, you know, I did all the machining. I did the pistons myself, the piston rings, the side rods I made from billets of steel. The drivers, I bought castings and the cylinders, too. But everything here, basically, is handmade, you know. I did have the boiler made. I didn't want to play around with, you know, doing my own boiler.
But what's the safety?
The safety valves went off at 125 PSI. I have two safety valves, and they go off at that speed. That means I'm ready to go, basically. I'm ready to run. So I'm going to push it out now and run it on the track.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's a good safety we have. We require them for the club to have a couple ways of feeding water into the boiler, too, at least two. I have axle pumps, two of them under here, and then I have a hand pump in the tender, and the tender holds about 18 gallons of water, which will keep me going for a good half a day at least. So, and well, I'm gonna go push it out right now, okay? Good question. It went from the coast from LA to San Francisco in the 1940s, and I think it might have been with the sunset or something and the colors and things. I guess that's why they call it the daylight. I'm not really sure.
With the locomotive on the tracks, it was now time to pick up its passenger car. As the locomotive was backing up to pick up its cars, disaster struck. A derailment.
On the ground. Oh, and it's fire.
Getting back on the tracks was way easier than a full-size locomotive, but way more difficult than getting my Lionel back on the track.
Somebody want to push it over towards you, get on this side?
Time to check the rail. I'm ready. Let's go for a ride.